Hey there, good to see you again. In this video, I want to show you a great online service I use called Powtoon. Now, I don't usually promote other people's products, but Powtoon is so cool, and you can use the logo creator with it to create some really amazing videos for your business, that I just had to show you what this was all about. Now, if you haven't yet jumped into the video creation bandwagon, maybe you're scared, maybe you just don't know what to create or even how to create a video, Powtoon is your ticket. Powtoon and the logo creator, of course. Now, before I jump into this tutorial, I do want to mention that Powtoon isn't free, but you can sign up for a free account and check it out as long as you want. But to test it out, you can right now, this very second, start with zero money. I want to show you the power of this tool and why I like it so much. So I've already signed into my own account. When you first start Powtoon, you'll notice, just like the logo creator, that it has templates. You can select any template you want to preview it. Let's take the first one. If you roll your mouse over it, you can kind of see exactly what the template is going to show you. But when I click on it, I can preview it. So when you can, hop over to Powtoon and take a look at all of the templates they provide. And keep in mind, you can always start with a blank template as well. So let me show you how easy it is to edit one of these templates. I'm going to click on the edit button and wait for it to load. And you'll notice a whole bunch of things. You're going to notice these little icons on the right. You're going to notice a bunch of icons on the top. And you're going to notice a slideshow like a PowerPoint or Keynote template type of layout on the left. So when you click on the first frame, you're going to notice it looks just like the thumbnail. Second frame, third frame, fourth frame, and you can add more and more frames as you create your video by clicking this little plus button. Now, I'm not going to get into a full-on tutorial on Powtoon. You can go to Powtoon and there's a billion tutorials. I'll show you that at the end of the video. But for my Logo Creator Loves Powtoon tutorial, I want to show you the basics. So the first thing you want to do is click on the first slide, and you'll notice there's a slider, okay? It looks complicated, but it's super easy. Watch. You can just click and drag the slider, and you'll notice that your video is presented to you, okay? So now let's come to the very first word. Boom, there's my words. So they roughly appear around 2 seconds. 2S means 2 seconds. 2.5 seconds. If I click it, just like the logo creator, it highlights. So if I double click it, I can change the text. Right? No problem. Okay, so let's rewind our movie, drag the slider to the left, and over here I see a play button, so I'm going to click it. Okay, my text has been changed. Now if I click and drag this up above this line, I'll be able to see it all. So let's rewind it, make sure it's cool. Great, so far so good. Now this little guy here, if I click on him, he's a built-in animation. You'll notice when I click on different pieces on the canvas here, this area also changes. So if I click on text, it shows me my text. If I click on the element, it'll show me the element. And you'll notice that if I click on the guy, here's my arrow, and I can see exactly where he's going to come in, around 3 seconds. Okay, easy. Now, you'll notice that he slides in from the left, and there's a hand that slides him in. This little arrow is the key to that. If I click on the arrow, I can make him come in from the top, from above, or pop in. Let's make him pop in instead. I'm going to rewind it, I'm going to play it, and watch him pop. Okay, the hand is still there, so let's remove the hand. Click on the pop, hand, no hand. Rewind it. popped in. Great. So let's say I don't want this guy bashing his head in with the computer. I can delete him easily. I just click on him and hit my delete key on my keyboard. Now over on the right, they've got a whole bunch of new animations that I can use. There's this guy. There's a screaming guy. Let's use a screaming guy. Click and drag it, just like the logo creator. I click and drag him. You'll notice down here the timeline has also changed. So I'm going to click on him. I'm going to make him bigger. And instead of coming in from the left, is what he's doing, see, he's doing that, I'm going to bring him up from the top, from the bottom. And also, I'm going to make sure a hand moves him up. Now watch what happens. My text. There he goes. Cool. Now you'll notice that it also has changed to the next slide. Now again, I'm not going to get into a giant tutorial on this. I just wanted to show you the basics of how this works. You can visit the website and check out all of their awesome tutorials. But let me quickly show you how I created the intro to Tutorial Tuesday using Powtoon and the logo creator. Let me show you. First, let's create a brand new blank canvas. When I hit create, I'm presented with all of the templates. I don't want any of these, I want to create my own. Here we are, blank canvas. I don't want the second frame, I don't want the third frame, delete, delete. I just want one frame. I want to choose a background for it. So again, Powtoon has a whole bunch of stuff over here on the right. If you click it, it changes the background. Now they have a whole bunch of stuff. You can go up here to the top right and click a couple of these guys and find lots more backgrounds. You can use solid backgrounds like this. It's pretty cool. So for my tutorial here, I happen to use this background here. So there's my background, easy enough. Now, in the logo creator, I created some text. Once I created my text, I went back to Powtoon, and I clicked this little button up here. It says image. I click it, and I've already imported these for the tutorial. So I'm going to click on the word tutorial that I made, and I'm going to insert my image. Okay, we don't want this to come in just yet. We want it to come in around 4 seconds or so. So there you go, just drag the little slider to about 4 seconds. Before the tutorial comes in, I want my logo creator logo there. So let's go back a bit, and I'm going to import my logo. If I find it, here it is, click it, insert image, here's my logo. And it pops in. So if I go over here to the play button, I can see exactly, let's rewind it, I can see how it's going to look. Pop. And tutorial comes in. So tutorial comes in, let's move it down, let's bring it in around 2 seconds, and I'm going to click on this little transition icon, and I want it to come up, and I also want it to come up with a hand. Now I rewind it. And play, boink, hands up. And now I want the final word Tuesday to pop up, so I need to import that. So I'm gonna go to image, find my Tuesday image that I created in the logo creator, insert, there's my Tuesday, I can move it here, I can make it small. Let's move him up. Now he is going to pop in from what? Let's try fading him in around 4 or 5 seconds. If I click on this, I click on the word fade, and now he should fade in. See how he fades in? Awesome. Rewind it, play, boink. Way too long. It takes too long for him to come in. So I'm going to back him up to about 4 seconds here, and now let's Now let's try it. Pop, up, and fade. I have a lot of extra frames here that I don't want. I just simply hit the minus button here, which deletes all the frames that I don't want. Okay, great. Now, if you've noticed at the very end of my intro video, it fades to a black screen. Let me show you how I did that. Come up here and make a new frame with the plus key. It's going to duplicate the same background and everything. And since I don't want it to transition to this green screen, I want to make a black screen. So I'm going to go back over here and find something with a black screen. So I happen to know the infographic icon has a black background. If I click it, it changes my canvas to black. And now, if I click on the first canvas, I want to transition this using any of their built-in transitions. If you notice, I can roll my mouse over these and see the transition. This kind of fades. This has a squeegee. This rolls to white. This pulls a light switch. I like that one. So if I click on the light switch one and I drag it over my canvas, it's a transition from the first slide to the next slide. So if you watch now, I'm going to rewind it all the way and we'll see this little guy click the light. Ta-da! Super easy. Once you're done with your video, you can go up here to the share button. And they allow you to upload it to YouTube and download it as an MP4 that you can bring into your video editing software or whatever. Okay, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this walkthrough of the Powtoon Studio. So go hop over, use the link below, and go visit the site and play with it. It's really cool. If you haven't started making videos for your business yet, you really should consider starting. And Powtoon, along with the logo creator, is the best way to start. See you next time.